Thank you. Thank you. Talking to no one. Oh, that's fine. No one's here. Damn it. Why does this microphone always crap out? I'm not really changing anything. Boy, do I just love talking and no one's there. Fuck. Well, maybe some people like the quiet and just watch. I don't know. Well, now I'm here, I guess. Oh well. Certainly an interesting brush. I don't know what I'm doing. Just clear when I don't check if my microphone is working before I start streaming. Well, should try out doing a quiet stream on purpose sometime. Not just because I messed up. Some people do that, just have the stream running. Quiet and chill, some music. I guess I could use these streams to sort of calculate how long it took me to draw all this. Then I'll know how to price it on VGen. Although I'm gonna need some people to actually want commissions first. It's an experiment, we'll leave it like that. Didn't I have like stardust? Something like that might help a little bit. Can't see that. We'll be right back. Said this file was a mess. I don't know what these random layers are. Pop up here and there. Banana touch them. I forgot a little horn jewelry. Horn? I mean ear. You know, the thing that I'm just drawing next to. I guess it should be silver to match the rest. Although I personally like to put gold on all my characters. right, we're getting there. Only the hair left, basically. Some white lines in the hair. We should give her a blush. Like this. Hehe. Do something with this log over here. In the background, which is not the best color for it, to be honest.
I'm not really sure.
Funny, I just realized these background textures are from a shop that's pretty nearby. I've definitely been there. I've looked at those fancy watercolor books. Why is it when I select this layer and I try to move it, it starts moving a different layer? It makes no sense, Clip Studio Paint.
Thank you. fine enough, I think. I don't think a frame is gonna look that good. So we'll just leave it. It would be nice if it actually used the preview function to tell me how big it's gonna be in terms of file size. It seems to only be doing that when I save as a JPEG, which is just weird. Should be able to calculate that with a PNG too, in my personal opinion. Okay, it's 5 MB. Because VGN is being annoying and not letting me upload. I think they have an 8 MB file limit. Like, come on. Just see if I can remember how I set up the Bali file, even if I still like it at this point. I have to scroll very far back to find it. Where is it? There's an Oleander in now from my D&D campaign that I also haven't finished. Where is he? It's... I keep forgetting that I saved him in a different folder. There. That's him. He's still pretty cute. had a example file somewhere of how this needs to be set up. Problem is, where did I save that? Oh, this is it, right? So I did like the head and everything and the hair. So arms would be next. Body top. It's just... Okay, so the top is the shirt and the chest. So arms are separately. Yes, top, bottom, and arms, which is good to know. So arms are separate. This was supposed to be from life 2D animation, but having someone animate that is very, very expensive. So no folder. Arms. Did they call it? L, arm, and R. They put lower arm, wrist cuff, upper arm as separate layers. So start with the upper arm. Just copy it the way they did it. Hopefully gonna be useful. See if I can even do this quality level of line. Oh, I'm still drawing this on my old tablet because now it doesn't. How big is this? 5,200 by 8,450, which was huge on my old tablet, but on the new tablets, I can't zoom in that much. I mean, I can, but it's gonna be pixely. Could zoom in a little bit. Let's see what line strength we have. That seems about right. I definitely wanted to change his color scheme so it matches with the VTuber model I have now and the overlay. I guess it shouldn't blend in completely. Well, the red hair sort of acts like a barrier. But yeah, go more pink-ish. She actually looks kind of pretty with red. Kind of didn't expect that, but... Thank you. do that on the coloring layer. I think as soon as just as long as I don't forget doing it completely. So we have the upper arm and lower arm, and I think that would be about here, where I would then switch to a different layer. That was almost good. Why is this bottom part always like a weird looking shoe? That's better. Oh, hi, Zombie and Arn. Hi, Shrimp. Welcome. I gotta squint a bit to read everyone. Hello, hi. Well, thank you so much for stopping by and raiding. Hello, hello. Nice welcoming screen when it's like zoomed in on the nipple. How y'all doing? I mean, it's just on brand for me. I'm finally getting back to this drawing my VTuber thing. I want to try and do a PNG tuber with my own art. So I haven't touched this in months. Yeah, it's good to see you again. I stream so irregularly, so it's not a surprise. Very, very productive, very chill. I have some time off. I'm recovering a bit from being ill, so but I'm well enough to stream. So I have finished my groupies earlier. I just had to finish the left character, who is sadly going to leave the group, but I wanted to finish it anyway. We have something to remember her by. Oh, when the lure commands. I want to say that's been there for quite a bit, I feel. But I'm happy to have you now. I'm trying to layer this whole thing, okay? You can't see my layers, but... Yay! The lurk command. Oh my god, Artemis! She jumped up without knowing that there was space for her. She almost fell down again. Have a good lunch, dinner, whatever you're doing. Thanks for raiding! For stopping by. Artemis, if you go in the kitchen, there's a snack for you there. I don't think you've eaten it yet. Hmm? Do you want to help me draw? but you have no thumb. You can hold the pen. My cat is being in my face. She's very food obsessed, but she didn't hear the automatic feeder go off, I think, so she missed her snack, which is just mildly worrying. Nah, she's fine. Just needs a bit of attention. Bring some food with me, guys. I'm kind of hungry. God, what was I thinking when I made these lines? I don't know. As long as it looks good. There. Maybe I'll go crazy and try and animate this myself, which would be very crazy, but we'll see. A viewer sent me a tutorial. I still have to watch it, but maybe. It kind of seems like it could be fun to do. I guess we'll do the lower arm and then the hand also on a different layer. Now I don't even know. Okay, this file doesn't have any layers for all the coloring. I assume when you export it, you just merge it all into one. Back-o-back shrimp, what did you get? Tell me it's something delicious. Sweetie, did you go in the kitchen and get you a snack? Oh, this is not my aunt, by the way. This is a practice file that kind of shows how you're supposed to set it up for animating afterwards. So I'm using it as a guideline. Ooh, noodles. I love carbs. I've been meaning to try to eat less carbs, but the less I eat, the more I'm like, I want noodles, and I want potatoes, and I want rice. Because my doctor, or I don't know who, oh, baby, what did she knock down? Oh my god. It was a die. My cat knocked down a die. I did not see what it rolled. I don't know if she's good. Carbs. Not those kind of carbs. Although carbs, the fish, are very delicious, I think. I know the greedy Chagoy meme of that big fish eating a whole spoon of like fish food and he's just massive. Thank you. That's me. I identify with that fish. Not to be like too needy, but this D&D group is not very appreciative when I post art. I just want attention, guys. Tell me I did well so I can feel good about myself. That's why I'm doing the whole thing. Oh, thank you, Shrimp. That's why I'm doing like the whole thing, posting online and streaming and shit. I just listen, we can go in deep and talk about childhood stuff and all, but yeah, I want attention. And my how should I say, not pet peeve, the thing I draw the worst, I would say, is feet. But I just kind of have to make myself draw them. Do we want to check out the feet that are down here? For the longest time, I still had the reference open of the feet. Like, look, this is an older piece, and they're not that bad. Oh, you can see them. There we go. They're not that bad, to be honest. Especially doing like a front view of them, that's just crazy. But I think they're not bad. I gotta get that feet poser on Steam when it's on sale next time. All the reviews are just people memeing on foot fetishes. But man, if you're a foot fetishist and it's like the perfect thing, I would be so hyped to find this. You can post feet however you want. There's different types of feet, I assume. Seems to be a very good program, actually. Speaking of food, I decided the rest of the week I'm just making like burritos. We call them just wraps usually. You know, basically you're making a salad and you're putting it in a wrap with some protein and then you eat it. It just becomes more delicious once you wrap it up in a tortilla and put some cheese on it. I mean, everything becomes more delicious when you put cheese on it. But depending what's in it, it's not too unhealthy, I would say. I'm doing my best losing a little bit of that chub I got going on. I don't know how pixely it looks. I'm just zoomed in a bit close, but it should be fine. fancy ass new tablet is like 4K resolution, so I have to make everything super huge. And this I think I started creating when I still had my old tablet. I think doing this all on different layers is gonna help, especially with the expressions. I have ears, mouth, nose, eyes, all on different layers, so I can come up with silly little expressions. Go ahead. But if I do an Ahegaho face, am I gonna get banned from Twitch? Because as a meme, it would be pretty good. You know the cum face, the sticking the tongue out, rolling your eyes back. It's like Ahegaho in Japanese. Because I try to do an emote with that, that's sort of like that, and Twitch was not happy, they denied it, I was not allowed to have it on the channel. Even though it's just like a little chibi guy. I don't even know if I should show it. Did I draw it on stream? I might have drawn it on stream. I don't know if you only get banned when someone reports you or if they have like automated AI that goes over your stream. I did one time, for a very brief moment, flash a penis and I did not get banned, so I don't know. It was a non-sexy penis, by the way. I mean, allegedly. I totally didn't do it. It was in a different stream, not on Twitch. I mean, the bot is gone anyway. It only saves for like 7 days, so I think I'm good. I mean, I would never purposefully do anything to get me banned. Is that I can't read. It is Farmer Sky, hi! You're dark blue on a black background, so I have to squint a bit. Hi. Good to see you. How are you doing? How's the other side of the world? Good idea. I'm a hydrate. I have this very cool skull glass. Zip, zip. Oh yeah, I got this new model. I haven't used it a lot yet. Oh, that's a good idea. Just chill a little bit. recharge your batteries and all that. I forgot who made it. It's called Cute Girl. It's in my credits, the model. I bought it from a Japanese site, so I was like, hopefully I'm doing everything correctly. And we are... I chose the smallest booby size, but we're gonna ignore that. Those are man titties. This is totally a male model. Got it? It's totally Vali. And not a cute girl. Oh wait, I'm doing upper arm, not lower. Yes, definitely very, very man. There is a version of this model where I can alter the textures, I believe, but it costs a bunch more money than I was not willing to pay. So it's only a recolor for now. We do have some free nipples here, you know. If I do manage to finish this at one point, I can do a PNG tuber. At least try to make one. Where should the cutoff be? About here, I would say. Yeah, mostly I want to do a PNG tuber, so it's, you know, my own art. And he actually looks like Vali because it is him. And not just a model I bought that I sort of recolored to look like him. Butterfree? Wait, that's... my German brain trying to come up with what Pokemon is that. I think it's Metbo in German, which is a weird name. Oh yeah, yeah, it is the one I was thinking of. There's a shiny that's pink. You know what? We can try a little bit of painting practice. See, he's got like a little pleading face going on there. So it is pink. Has like, oh, this is such a nice color combination. Way cuter than the regular version. I kind of made it a little bit chubby. Someone fed it a lot of treats. Me if I were a Pokemon trainer. Oh, thank you. I want to say it's probably just practice. I kind of do that as a warm-up sometimes, just draw a bunch of circles. Mm-hmm. eye, so the eye goes a bit more in the red. Looks like a happy little guy. We need the wings, of course. This is such nostalgia. Oh, that's so sweet. She is happy. Of course, me as a little girl, I so loved this Pokemon. If I had known back then there was a shiny version that was pink, I would have gone insane. When did they introduce shinies? Because I didn't know about them until like very recently. When was Gold Silver? Might have been once I didn't really play that much anymore. But definitely where I could have still learned about them. But yeah, it was pretty recently that a friend, she's all about catching those shinies. And I was like, the fuck is a shiny? And then turns out they've been like a thing for a very long time. And I played quite a few Pokemon versions that aren't too old recently, but do you think I got a single shiny? I did not. Hence, I did not know about them. I might not have even recognized one if I've seen it. And that kind of makes me feel a little bit old, but maybe I am. It amuses me that she's so chubby. She's just... she keeps her love in the belly. Why she's so chubby. Let's see, I'm not... that great at this sort of like painting style. I'm kind of figuring it out as I go along. I don't know what I'd do. But I hope you like it. Kind of adorable, if you ask me. A chubby little butterfree. Yay. It's like maybe like a cat. This butterfree also has a cat pouch where all her secrets are stored. Because that's what cats do with their pouches, if you didn't know. It's where they keep their secrets and their plans for world domination. It's the funniest thing when I let Artemis into the hallway and she goes up and down the stairs and her pouch jiggles from left to right. I can't even shame her because I am also chubby, but it looks very funny. Fun when you throw random Pokemon or creatures at me. It's good practice. Now I'm a little bit obsessed with a shiny Butterfree, because so cute. That's actually kind of the color palette I am going for this valley. Like pink and red. Oh my gosh, in the Google search is the Bye Bye Butterfree scene. I cried. I cried so much when Ash had like let go of Pokemon. I'm like, no, I want them to be friends forever. Never grow old. I think if I watched the episode where he actually becomes Pokemon Master, I would cry like a baby. Because it's been so long, and it's such childhood. Even though I haven't watched Pokemon in a long time. Watching the first Pokemon movie in the cinema, and we were kind of already the oldest people there. We're like teenagers, my brother and I. There were a lot of kids there, and I think we both cried. Even my brother, who would never admit it. Because I think it's that bit where Oh no, Ash just like turned to stone. And then all the Pokemon cry and save him with their tears? Looking back, I'm like, who thought of this? But I was definitely crying. Oh, my friend sent me a cat picture. Cats are so silly. The star always gives me trouble. I'm gonna try my best. Oh my god! Practice does make perfect. Look at that. That's a good star. It is the seven-pointed star that is the symbol of the goddess of magic in my setting. So a lot of times all the witches that I draw, you know, they live in my setting. It's a good accessory for them to have. Though Vali probably doesn't know what it means, he just thinks it's pretty and shiny. Because he is not a smart boy. Yesterday I saw a great video by Trixie Mattel, and she's releasing a new makeup line, and it's called Gamer, like gay gamer. Like, girl, this is brilliant. I want it all, please. There's actually some good eyeshadow there that I would like to have, but that stuff always sells out really quickly. And the pink liner is called Finish Her, as a Mortal Kombat reference. I want it so bad. We'll be right back. think I got her stuff like once. And man, the custom fees, they're killing me. I was always gonna ask, what are you guys doing on the weekend? But it's Tuesday. Although I guess the question could still stand. I'm doing D&D this weekend. And I think for once people are gonna come to my place, which is the furthest from everyone. But it's actually quite big. So I'm always eager to entertain people here. Technically, yes. It should be something I am capable of doing, so... I guess I'm not good at drawing robots and shit. What else? Furry can be a little bit of a challenge, I would say. I might also do it off stream, and I could also put in a little bit more effort. It all depends, I guess, on my mood. Doodle is more like, has to draw a Gundam. No, please. I don't know. I mean, I could try. It might look like a really shitty Gundam. I seen a big one when I was in Tokyo. I think it was when we went to Odaiba, where there is this kind of wannabe hot spring thing, like a little village that you can experience. And there was also like a TV studio, I think, on this like island in Tokyo. The only downside was when we got there, it said no tattoos. And I'm like, well, fuck. I kind of sneaked in anyway, because I wasn't gonna bathe in front of other people. I just wanted to, like, walk around. So I sneaked in with, like, a jacket over my arm to hide the tattoo that's on my lower arm. And it worked! I wonder, should this lower part also be part of the top? Let's see how they did it. Yeah, top is just the whole thing. Torso bone, hair, coat, collar, a neck. Oh goodness. Yeah, so that's sort of the whole torso. Thank you. think I could add the slower part. I didn't do the neck on a separate layer. Should... Oh no. Artemis, do not think about jumping on that shelf. Baby, I'm talking to you. Don't sniff in that direction. Baby. Why are you sniffing like this? She looks like she's gonna jump on the shelf that's 100% gonna get destroyed if she decides to jump on it. And that shelf holds quite a few figures. Yes, my cat's name is Artemis. Oh, when I say baby, I'm also... I mean, if you want, I can call you guys baby also. But then my cat might get a little bit confused. Yeah, she was looking very interested at this show. Which is quite dangerous. I think I should definitely separate the neck area, just in case I do animate anything like that. I assume the neck is part of where you tilt the head like this. Baby, stop looking up like this. I don't like it. She's normally too lazy to jump on high things anyway, so I never had to worry about it. But I don't like the look in her eyes. Into Sky, get that look out of your eyes. I told her. She looks at me like, okay, I can only see half her expression because I'm not wearing my glasses, so I'm assuming a lot of things here. Okay, she jumped down from the chair, that is good. Where did she put the neck? Just in the top. Where did I put the neck is the question. also here, okay. Did Lo-Fi Girl crap out on us? Okay, there we go. Oh, Twitch keeps saying like my bitrate is really unstable. It says like 6,000 kilobytes per second, but also says unstable. Is the stream good for you guys? Like a high quality, smooth and everything. Yeah, I got the whole new glass fiber, I don't know if that's correct English translation, and a new router and stuff, so I figure maybe it's just some compatibility issues. Like it does say the upload is fine, so it's good to know. Just Twitch being a little bit confused, I feel. It's a fiber network, okay. Okay, now we're going to the bottom part. Why did I put in all these details? So how did they set up the bottom? It's just skirt and legs. Okay, so whatever I guess you want to be able to move, you put on a different layer. And then there's a left leg and a right leg. Because this guy's ready to party. His idea of partying is probably killing a delicious animal and then eating it and then running around with his wolf family because he was raised by wolves. That is his backstory. So I guess we'll make a layer for the loincloth thing here in the front. And the part of it that is in the back. And I think the accessories that are on here, I'll just put on the thigh layer. And the lower leg layer. And the foot layer. I do think he looks actually like this is kind of an old artwork, but it still looks really good. Which I'm very self-critical. That rarely happens to me. Where I'm like, oh, this old piece still looks really good. let's go. I actually made Vali a part of my D&D character's backstory. So they both live in the same swamp. And Ferox, my D&D character, has been the one that taught him how to wear any clothes at all. They met when Vali was very naked. So he had to be like, can you please put on some clothes? They're pretty much the only regular humanoids in that swamp. Ferox's mom also lives there, who is a hag. She taught Ferox all the magic and stuff. And that's also why sometimes people visit the swamp, because they might want to make a deal with the hag. And I assume, I would say that Bali's parents also among those, except they didn't survive. And then a little wolf pack came and adopted him. Because he was just so dang adorable, they couldn't eat him. Also, he's clearly sort of magical. Probably were some quite intelligent wolves. Come on, get that curve. There we go. And then he grew up learning how to hunt and stuff. And whenever he'd find some lost person's belongings, he would get all the shiny things from there, because they are pretty to look at. He's a simple boy with simple wants and needs. And whether he has got it going on with the wolves, then, you know, I'll leave it up to people's imaginations. Actually, I think he probably tried, and the wolves were like, what the fuck, you're not a wolf? Get out of here. Thank you. Trying to silently motivate myself to finish this line art. Shouldn't take too much longer, I think. A pretty good job with the sketch. So you're just trying to do it a little bit neater. Ugh, not like this. A little bit funny apparently when I'm leaning down, or maybe I'm involuntarily kind of leaning to the side when I'm drawing, but I see it like out of the corner of my eye the model is doing it. Has long legs. Really, if he just cleaned up a little bit, could be a model. Like, I mean, when you live in a swamp and it's very humid and everything, this boy stinks. Which I've adopted with Ferox 2, this attitude. Our Dini characters just got into a city. And another character was like, oh yeah, let's get a bath. And Ferox is like, no, I'm good. I don't need a bath. I wonder how long I can make do that joke before other characters force me to take a bath. Forgot to erase that. We'll be right back. gosh, so productive today. I even started my day. I usually get up and I do my dailies because I'm an idiot and play both Genshin Impact and Honkai Star Rail. And I have a little treadmill at home that when I can get my ass up, I start up when I do my dailies and I just walk. It's a literal grind, yeah. Leveling up my Luo Cha because I finally got him after like 3 banners. And I want those free gems and everything, whatever they're called. But yeah, I try to motivate me, and I feel like it's gotten a little bit easier to do it. Honkai Star Rail. I keep forgetting there's Honkai the Third, I think it's called. I'm not gonna stop playing that also, because then I have no time to do anything else. But yeah. So I ended up walking for an hour on the treadmill while I'm doing all that and some other stuff. Which my body desperately needs because I don't get my ass up otherwise. So I think that's pretty good. I have this little fitness watch. No, Bai Luo is so shitty compared to Luo Cha. I thought she was pretty good for a while, but then I realized she doesn't remove debuffs. And even Natasha does that, who is a 4-star. And I'm committed to collecting beautiful boys, so she's kind of very, very strong. But I'm still not gonna roll for her because Aventurine is coming on the next banner, I think. And I have to have him, obviously. But yeah, I'm sorry you ended up with Bai Luo instead of Acheron. I don't even know how to pronounce him. Because that hurts. That hurts. That was me the last two. I tried 2 times to get Luo Cha. I'm so glad they're already doing the double banners in Honkai Star Rail. So I didn't have to wait as long to try and get him again. I'm so hyped to have him now. And he's so good. He heals everything and he removes debuffs and removes buffs on the enemies and he does damage. So he's like, he's a crazy healer. I guess Bai Luo, I mean, I have used her for a long time. She's definitely better than Natasha in terms of how much she can heal. So she's saved my ass a bunch of times. Plus, like, she and Danhang are, like, buddies now. So, you can have them hang out together. And she can learn from him. He's in almost all my parties because he's also so OP in terms of strength. He's one of the most beautiful designs in the game, though. Like, I would have actually spend money if I hadn't gotten him. Plus, he stands like a slut on the character selection screen. Like, he has his back arched for some reason. And I'm like, why are you doing that? Do you want other men to grab your waist? I still have to, oh, so many things on my list. I've been meaning to draw Nuvilet and Danheng together because they're both like water dragons and they both have this animation of like rain falling. So I'm like, okay, clearly they have to kiss at one point. Clearly. Yes, you get me. And they're both kind of like, I don't want to say antisocial, but more like they don't necessarily know how to get along with humans or how to talk to them. So they can like give each other tips on how to talk to humans that are just like terrible. But they're like encouraging each other. Also a Zhongli and Welt pick because they're both voiced by the same guy. So that's enough for me to ship something. Do you put the knees? That. Okay, the knees on the lower leg. Also, they're both old men. Both old men characters. So much potential. Ooh, has anyone done Kaelas and Aether? The Traveler and the Trailblazer? That would also be a good idea. I'm sure someone's already done it. Like, I'm definitely not the first person to think of that. Where does the foot start? Like here, maybe? I'll just do it like that, I think. I think my next fan art might be some Heaven Official's Blessing fan art. Because the person I use a lot for like pose references posted. So something that was very specifically for Heaven Official's blessing. And it's been a while. I miss those doofuses. Let's go, right leg. We are literally on the last leg of this journey. Oh, that was terrible. I do have to figure out if I have to draw these things a little differently. Like, for example, the hair is just what peeks out from the side. But I think in here, when you remove all this, you know, there's a whole back to it. So I might have to add that. I don't know. Most of the time, I don't know what I'm doing, so I'll have to work it out as I go along. But that's just life, me and life, going through life. Pretending to know what I'm doing. if I've decided if that's jewelry or an actual plant around his leg. I'm thinking it's probably a plant. Because he hasn't showered in so long that things start growing on him. Something like that. Just like a little good berry spell that's growing there. You could just pluck it and eat it. I just realized I missed the perfect opportunity to use the good berry spell. But I did get us rations in the game for our travel. But I guess if we have to travel again, I can just be like, hey, that's actually useful as well. It's like Lembas bread. You can just eat a good berry. But it was funny to see that it was actually in Baldur's Gate 3. Like, when am I going to use that in Baldur's Gate? It's not like you can eat a good berry when you're down. Unless someone else can shove a good berry in your mouth. I don't know if you can do it in the game. But you get so many healing potions, healing, short rest, all of that. Although I wonder if you can use a good berry in camp, like when you're selecting camp goods to eat. Maybe that's what it's for. Gosh, guys. Okay, I left out the headdress because I wasn't sure if I'm going to animate it, but if I'm doing a PNG tuber, I guess I could do it. Oh no, I did do it. I am done. Hi, Shumpy. Thanks for stepping in. As I'm gonna finish up, actually. It's almost time for food. And I just finished the line work for this. Lots of stuff that's gonna come in on the painting layer. So the freckles, for example, the lips and all that stuff, the nipples. Have a good rest for me as I'm gonna get up now and make some dinner. I said at the beginning when my mic was off, I don't know if I'm gonna do a stream Friday. I hope so. It would actually be super fun to continue to draw this, like, color this all in. It is afternoon, but I have a weird eating schedule. So, it is dinner for me. Oh god, is it Zombien or Zomblen art? I cannot read. At least, well, thank you for the raid earlier. And bringing on good shrimp. Thanks for hanging out lurking. I'll post the Butterfree in the server. So you can have it. Okay, thank you, it's an L, yes. That's the glasses thing. It's me squinting. Okay. Yeah, thank you guys. Oh, I'll see you soon. Might be drawing Friday again. Have a good rest of your day. Bye-bye.